Hey everyone! So I'm here with a little DIY project. I don't really do many DIY projects on my channel. I do them like off my channel, but not on my channel. So I recently rearranged my room, and if you follow me on, I think, my Aries Trash Instagram, you would know that I'm like slowly in the process of getting my space, kind of like the changing up the theme of it, and I've been loving the whole I love pastels, but I've been loving the whole shabby chic look, and that is what I'm going for. So I rearranged my room and I took down a lot of stuff that I had on my walls. Also, if you follow me on my Instagram, or if you've seen any of my like craft space videos, you would know that I have like these squared, like these tiled corkboards that are like purple, green, and blue. Anyway, I took those down and I'm gonna repurpose them into this. This is a corkboard. It is, the back is kind of disgusting looking, but that's the part that's gonna be in the wall. It is an embroidery hoop, and this is cork. I just wrapped it with some new fabric. This is beautiful fabric that I got from Shabby Fabrics. It's very shabby chic. It will match my walls. My walls are this mint color. It's like a deep mint green color. My room does need like a paint job, so I'm thinking of painting it, keeping the mint, but painting it a lighter color. And so I think this will match really well with the color that I picked out. But yeah, so this, I'm going to show you how I made this. Again, I repurposed those tiles. So if I bring all this stuff here, what you're going to need is an embroidery hoop. I got this at Michael's. This is a 10-inch hoop that I got at Michael's. I have some E6000 glue, which is probably like my favorite wet glue like ever. It's like a mix between hot glue and super glue. It's like, it's awesome. I love it. I just have this because this is the marker that I use. It's American Crafts marker that I use to trace the circle. And I have a box. It's like a box cutter. You can use an X-Acto knife. Honestly, I didn't know where my X-Acto knife was. And I was cleaning out my space and I'm just like, oh, this is my dad's knife, whatever. So I have that. And this is the fabric. So since this is a 10-inch hoop, I cut these guys out too small. I cut them 11 inches. They needed to be a little bit bigger, but I made it work. And so this is the fabric that I'm using. And okay, this is what my cork boards were. I made these out of two, like this. You can get the really cheap cork tiles. There are two cork tiles in here glued together, and then this was an old t-shirt that my mom was getting rid of. Actually, they were all old t-shirts, and I just covered it and everything, but you know, I kind of want the shabby chic look. So this is just a regular cotton linen, beautiful fabric, Shabby Fabrics. I'll be sure to leave a link down below. Love that. So what I did was I kind of cut off all of this t-shirt, and then I took the inside hoop and I'm gonna trace and then cut it out. And like I said, there are a total of two tiles in here, and I'm gonna use both, and that's where the glue comes in. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut this. This was only glued at the back part, so this section here is not glued down. Because if it was glued down, it would be really weird when you put the tacks in. Like, this middle part of this one is not glued down either. So all that's glued down is like the edges. So it's nice and stretched over. It's kind of like when you stretch a canvas, you stretch them over and then you adhere it on the edge. That's basically what I'm doing, but with the embroidery hoop. So let me cut this guy off. Mm-hmm. really cheap. These tiles, look, can you see how thin they are? They're super, super cheap tiles. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is now I'm going to trace. And just for size, these tiles are 12 by 12. So anything like 11 inch hoop or 10 inch hoop would work. This is what I'm using, this marker. It's like really sloppily, but it's fine. If you notice the other one is not very well cut, totally fine. Just putting a cutting mat under here. I cut this one on, like the first one, I cut it on the floor. So I'm doing this on my desk so you can all see. So I'm just gonna take it and I'm just gonna cut. If it's really cheap cork, it'll just cut. And like I said, it doesn't have to be completely perfect because you're gonna fit it into this and you're gonna glue everything down and you're not even gonna see the cork. And so basically I just cut the first layer of cork since mine are glued together. It's that first layer. And then I'm just gonna work around the circle again to take off the second layer. And this one, when I did it on the first try, it didn't come up very well either. No. Let's see if I can rip this guy up. I think what I ended up doing, I ended up flipping it and then retracing it. Then I'm just gonna throw this out. Like I said, it's really, really cheap cork. You can tell because it's like everywhere now. Now that that is all cut, I'm gonna take the middle piece, the piece that goes in the middle, and I'm just gonna try to fit this together. These are the two pieces of cork. I want this one. I want this to be the front side. So I'm just kind of fit it in. But it should fit. And then I'm going to fit this one in on top of it. Okay, I think that's gonna fit in there. Good. So once I have that, that's where the glue comes in. I'm gonna glue these two cork pieces together. Now the tricky thing about using the E6000 is that it takes a while for it to bond. So if you're going to use it, you have to be very careful this next step. So once that is all glued together, I'm going to put the fabric on top. Now for this, I'm gonna have to glue here. I'm gonna have to glue the edges just to glue this piece of fabric down, only because I cut it too short. So that is what I'm gonna do. Now I'm gonna take this, which, you know, you unwind through here, and if you ever like did a, I don't know, what do you put like a fabric or a canvas over embroidery? It's just simple, you just kind of squish it all in together. I just wanted to glue it down so that my fabric doesn't move too much. See, like this is kind of bubbling up here, so I'm just gonna pull that a bit, and then what you do is you tighten it. So I'll screw it back up, tighten that. So I have that on. And so now you see the back needs help. This is where I do like intense gluing. Because like I said, this stuff doesn't really dry instantly. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of add more glue. Add as much glue to the cork and to the edges here. These edges here. You see I have all this excess fabric. I will cut that off, but for now, I'm gonna glue this edge and then I'm gonna fold the fabric down. This is just a means of making sure everything stays together, really. So I'm seriously ODing on the glue here, but that is just, I'm ensuring that it does not move, you know, that it doesn't come apart. And then once the glue is dried and everything, you'll see, if you use it, you'll see that it's not gonna come apart. What I'm gonna do now is, I'm gonna actually put this under something heavy so it will stay together. And then I'll come back and show you the finished project. Okay, I'm back with my cork boards. I just kind of want to show you one thing. Mistakes do happen. So I kind of sat this cork board, this is the one that I did just now on film. I sat it upside down and the glue ran. And it's now on this front here, and E6000 does dry like that, so it'll be stained like that. So this one unfortunately is stained. I mean, I can redo it, but I don't want to ruin this. If you see, I already have holes poked because I was trying to figure out how to rearrange decoration. So I'm gonna decorate these. Let me first decorate this one just to show you how I'm thinking of covering up those spots. I pulled out all, these are like little, I have a whole bag, but I pulled out all of these cards and stuff. These are the ones that I accumulated on my previous board. So I have tons of them here, and I pulled out a few that I liked. So these, I just kind of put a doily. I used my tape and I put a little bit of the glue on the back. So that way, if I want to change it out, I can just rip it off and still use the doily. So I think this one, I wanted it over here to cover that section up. And then I took out some cards that I wanted to use. So these, this is packaging from Kiki K. These are some cards. I have a bunch of them that I decorative. So I pulled out some. This is a tag from an old Planner Society kit. This is also from Planner Society. And then I took this photo. I have a bunch of spare photos. And I kind of matted it on white, and then I use one of the Planner Society post-its to put it on the back, and I think I want that here, and then I kind of wanted something, I think it was this one here, and then this down here for this one. These are going to go on my wall, and I kind of wanted them to be like really, really cute and decorative. If you've seen my other cork board, I kind of used it as a more of like an inspiration board, but it became sort of like a catch-all. Everything that I got like in the mail, I'll show you like little things like this. This is from Ink Road sticker. This is from Felicity Jane. These are from Coco Daisy. Like any little thing like this. This is also Ink Road, Felicity Jane, Vila Beautiful. I have tons of Reset Girl. This is from Two Little Bees, more Reset Girl. All those little pieces that you get in like your Happy Mail would go up on this board that I had. Any spare photos that I printed out for scrapbooking that didn't fit, I just threw it up there. But this one, I kind of wanted to make it themed, of course. So I'm going with the whole shabby chic, so I'm pulling out those things. Like, this was from a Happy Mail. This card says hello. Of course, this was from my kit and stuff like that. But I wanted to pull out things that'll fit my theme. So I kind of pulled out these flowers. These are from Maggie Holmes' Bloom. It was like a little ephemera bit, and it's just these adhesive flowers. You take off the backing and it's on a little foam. So I put them on these flat, I have these flat thumbtacks that I bought off of Amazon, and they're gold. So I kind of already put a few of them on, so they look like little, kind of like little roses. And I'm gonna use those decoratively, see? And now it looks like a little rosebud. But yeah, this is how I want this one to be. So I have these thumbtacks. I have tons of thumbtacks, but I picked these guys out only because the colors kind of match. Not so much that one. The colors kind of match. They're very light. They kind of match, and it has like a little gold feel to them. I don't know if you can see. They're from American Crafts. Ooh, if I put them like that between my fingers and focus, you can see them better. So like those colors I think would work really, really well. So I'm gonna use those as well. So I'm just gonna go ahead and start decorating. I think I have this one laid out the way I wanted. So I'm just going to start putting them down. And I never poke holes in my cards. I kind of just scooch them under. So I think that's how I want this one to look. So now I'm going to work on the other one, which is this one. I know I wanted this over here, and I think this, no, is it this here? And I know I wanted this here, this here, and then I was trying to figure out what to put here. Right, and I was trying to figure out what to put up here. And so I had taken out some embellishments. These are just like spare embellishments, you know, ephemera. This is kind of like a mixture of different things. I was thinking about those. Or that, it's cute. camera. No. I was thinking about this, and then I thought maybe I can put this over here, like that. That look cute there. Maybe if I move this over a little bit. I can put this kind of like that. Then I kind of wondered how I would glue it down. I don't know. But I thought this would go some, could go somewhere. Because it was cute. But I still need something there. So I do have a bunch of these little pictures. Or, again, I have these cards, you know, the ones that you get in the mail. And then I thought maybe I should just go into my, my Project Life stash, maybe. I didn't even think of doing that until just now. So, I might go and pull out some cards. So I changed out the card, I kind of like this card better. I found it when I decided to look through my stash. It's from October, oh man, October 2015 Project Life Kit. It says be kind always. I just love that look there. Then I was thinking, I had this one here. I can do that, then I still need something there, and that was the whole point. Was to have something. I mean, that could work. Love this. I kind of want to use it somewhere. So for this, I think I am going to... Well, this one, I can just peel this off. Stick it on the back of one of these guys. Just like that. Then we can just stick it down anywhere. Oops. But for this one, I think I'm gonna put this one here like that. So I need to glue this to the back of this. I'm trying to figure out which glue to use. I would use the E9000, it's just that the E9000 takes a while to dry. E9000. E6000. Oh my goodness. E6000. I think I might just go fetch that. Let me go do that. Alright, so I have it here. I'm just going to put a little bit on this thumbtack here. gonna go there, but I'm gonna have to let that sit for a bit because, like I said, this glue takes a bit to dry. I think that's gonna go there, and then now I have this flag, not flag, kite that I want to use. I was thinking, is that glue? Well, that is a bit of glue here. Never noticed that. Well, for now, I'm gonna put this down here. But that little flower cluster is gonna go there. I kind of want to use this flag. I don't know if I want to put it here. Maybe move these guys a little over. Like move them over just a little bit. To fit that flag there. This would have to go up a bit. Then this would go here. These guys would go down here a little bit. Let's see if I can get rid of that hole. No, this is gonna go up here. This is gonna go down here. And then that flag can be there. Let's see, let's test that. And then for that one, I probably want to do the same thing and put it on the back of a tack and then tack it on. I mean, I could also put a little adhesive and like kind of pinch it on like that, maybe. Too much, but that is gonna be here eventually, just like that. But I think that's it. I think both of these are finished. I'm just gonna let this one dry before I put it down. But yeah, so these are my corkboards. I will include photos of them at the end of the video. I hope you liked this little DIY. Thank you for joining me on this DIY. It's really hard to do DIYs. You would think filming a DIY is kind of like filming a plan with me video, but like I think the plan with me videos are a lot easier than a DIY video. This was very difficult. Like to do it and film it and be in frame and everything. Anyway, I will leave photos of these two corkboards. I'll take them on my wall so you can see how I'm gonna put them up. And of course close-up shots, especially with that little flower cluster there once it dries. But I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you always for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you like. Subscribe if you wish, and I will see you all next video. Bye.